well as economic development and quality. Since this debate, the government pledge has been passed into the education system. Which we see, Madam Chair, that the status quo, there is this necessity. We see that in the national budget, you know, education is only third in allocation. And we see within the potential that we can do better than that, Mr. Chair, Madam Chair, members of this House. We see that in status quo, you know, there is a necessity. There is a shortage, Madam Chair, of facilities. We see students, you know, being crammed in this very small classroom, so, you know, like, with a ratio of one teacher to 50 students. And we see that as a problem, Madam Chair. And we see, you know, that there are few competent teachers to handle that sort of scenario, Madam Chair. It's unfair to put them in that kind of setting. Secondly, Madam Chair, we also say that in status quo, there's a backward system. Because government, you know, doesn't put that much effort, Madam Chair, as you see in status quo, ladies and gentlemen. The mechanisms coming from government, Madam Chair, is this. We want to support the limit. We want to heighten standards in elementary, tertiary, and secondary levels. We say, Madam Chair, that we can't, you know, support every course in tertiary level. That's why we want government to continue enhancing its programs like scholarships given by TESPA and whatnot. Please later, sir. Whatnot, Madam Chair, ladies and gentlemen. Secondly, Madam Chair, we want to increase, you know, stricter implementation. We want to look at them and we want them to give total transparency, Madam Chair, ladies and gentlemen. And we want at some point to increase the budget given by government to the educational system. And you know, intensify monetary, you know, debt end with the end of the day. Most of all, Madam Chair, please later, sir, we want to prioritize, you know, these important facilities, these supplies that government give to schools, like for example, libraries in public schools, Madam Chair, ladies and gentlemen. Because we see that these kind of facilities in a school is lacking, Madam Chair. We see that the books in public schools, Madam Chair, public school libraries are sometimes outdated already, Madam Chair. And government needs to look at that at the end of the day. We also want, Madam Chair, to increase facilities in these schools. We want them to share projects like building new proper classrooms for these schools by the end of the day. Standards coming from government are these. You know, which will best suit the needs of the economy and which will best forward the welfare of students and teachers. But before I proceed, yes sir.
I think when we talk about education that suits the needs of the economy, we want to zero in on the college level or vocational level, because that is the point when people choose what profession they want to pursue. It's not just that, and it's also a good chair.
Madam Chair, you know, in our paradigm, we cater to children, Madam Chair, because we believe that, you know, in this level, it's best to start, you know, making them competitive, Madam Chair. Because in that level, if you don't look at them like that, if you don't cater them, Madam Chair, you know, they will be having a hard time when we get that tertiary level. In our paradigm also, Madam Chair, you know, we also cater to the tertiary level, and we also want to, you know, improve that level. By the end of the day. Look, that first argument coming from Prime Minister is talk about the debt limits, Madam Chair. Because we say, if you don't prioritize, you know, education, it affects the individual. It affects these students very much, Mr. Chair, ladies and gentlemen. Let's talk about, you know, these children, Madam Chair. Let's talk about how these pupils or students are, you know, unique in every way. We say this, there's no one system, you know, one size fits all. And the same, Madam Chair, that you have to cater to their individuality. And it's not like, Madam Chair, you know, in a classroom that's filled with 50 students or so. It's impossible for a teacher to look after them, Madam Chair, and ladies and gentlemen. And we say that if that is the kind of ratio present in society, in a classroom, Madam Chair, we say that the students will have very hard time understanding, Madam Chair. Let's look at the condition inside that classroom. There is a lot of students, Madam Chair, a very small classroom and a lot of students. We see that it's very hard for students to understand. And they lose, Madam Chair, the interest in learning because they're the very, very bad. And the teacher doesn't anymore know, the teacher's voices wouldn't anymore reach them or something like that, Madam Chair. In that classroom, Madam Chair, it's very hard to nurture, you know, proper education by the end of the day. And we say, Madam Chair, that if that's something, if that's the problem at such a level, Madam Chair, it will affect your competitiveness. We say, Madam Chair, that it affects their effectivity when they get to college level, Madam Chair. Yeah. And it's something that is very detrimental by the end of the day. We also say that, you know, this is very crucial because parents, you know, invest in that, Madam Chair. There's a big budget out of the family budget, Madam Chair, ladies and gentlemen. And government should acknowledge that, Madam Chair. Government should, you know, respect the kind of effort that the parents are putting. And government should put in the same effort, Madam Chair, ladies and gentlemen. Because, Madam Chair, we believe that the children or that the students in this nation would be the building block for this nation's progress by the end of the day. And that's why we want to start at that level, Madam Chair, and continue on until college level, ladies and gentlemen, members of this House. Before I proceed,
I think it hurts. Okay,
also, Madam Chair, I want to talk about the teachers in this scenario. We say, Madam Chair, that they have the right enhancements. And in that situation, Madam Chair, you know, the teacher doesn't have that enough of opportunities. Because it harms her in a very detrimental way. And she lacks motivation by the end of the day, Madam Chair. She becomes ineffective in that particular classroom. And government should take a look at that and cater to that, Madam Chair, members of this House. We also say that this is very important for the progress of the economy. Because the Philippines, Madam Chair, largely depends on, you know, exportation of labor. And we say that it's very crucial for government to keep that up, Madam Chair. Because also, Madam Chair, because of that exportation, you know, there's still left in the Philippines. And we say, Madam Chair, that we have to produce, you know, equal quality in all our workers. So that when we export them, Madam Chair, there's still going to be people, competent professionals inside the Philippines by the end of the day. That's how important, Madam Chair, you know, funding this education system is in this debate. Because we believe, Madam Chair, that it's very important for government to look at education as something that's a building block and the very foundation of a nation, Madam Chair,